Lanthanum is the first element in the series called the rare earths. They're not terribly rare, but nevertheless, they're called rare earths. And they all have rather similar names. So there is quite an amusing little rhyme, mnemonic, that people learn to remember the names, which, and the first two letters of each word tell you this chemical symbol, the elements. So this, it goes, languid centaurs praise Ned's promise of small European garden tubs, dinosaurs hobble erotically thrumming yellow lutes, which takes us from lanthanum all the way to lutetium.
Lanthanum is the largest of the lanthanides. It's a prototype for the lanthanide series, and because it's the largest, it is the most reactive. It's a strange metal in that you can actually cut it with a knife, so it's not actually that hard.
I haven't worked much with lanthanum, but one of my students, or a Russian visitor, did some rather interesting experiments with making a compound of lanthanum and copper, so-called lanthanum cuprate, which is quite an interesting catalyst.
Lanthanum's got quite a few technological uses. It's used in, of all things, lighting in Hollywood studios. Lanthanum can also be used in hydrogen storage. Now, obviously, the hydrogen economy is becoming a very important issue with the energy crisis and so on and so forth. And it's, in certain circumstances, it's very effective as what we call a hydrogen sponge. So it can suck up all of the hydrogen, and then hopefully you could use it as a fuel source. But because it's quite heavy, it might not be actually that useful at the end. But it's good to know that it can do that.